Good morning. This is Pastor Zach with the Goodland United Methodist Church with your morning devotion for Monday, November 20th. Today I'll be reading from Hebrews chapter 11, verse 11. By faith, he received the power of procreation, even though he was too old, and Sarah herself was barren, because he considered him faithful who had promised. I'm going to read to you today a reflection that comes from the writings of Martin Luther in a book called Faith Alone, a Daily Devotional. Luther writes, "The Bible clearly shows that promises of physical blessings also include spiritual blessings. We weren't created for an existence like the cattle and donkeys. Instead, we were created for eternity. When God gives us a promise, he doesn't limit himself to our physical needs. He's isn't only concerned about our stomachs. He also wants to keep our souls from being destroyed and wants to give us eternal life. Consequently, promises concerning external and physical matters are like the shell of a nut. But the real essence or inner kernel is Christ and eternal life. God who makes the promises isn't speaking to donkeys and cattle. As Paul points out in 1 Corinthians, is it about oxen that God is concerned? Rather, he's concerned about intelligent human beings created in his image to live with him for eternity. Clearly, the promises of physical blessings are like the nuts and apples we use to get the attention of our children. God gets our attention with physical blessings so that we will learn to appreciate eternal blessings. This is how God encourages us to expect eternal life. God's purpose in giving us food and water isn't merely that we eat and drink without thinking, as horses and donkeys do. Rather, he gives us physical blessings so that we will realize that he is loving and kind. This will help us to believe he will take care of all of our needs. Even if God gave us only a piece of straw, he would want us to acknowledge him as the eternal God whose kindness is overflowing. If we still believe in him, we will have eternal life. Even though Abraham didn't see all these promises fulfilled in his own lifetime, he still believed God. That's why he was given eternal life." We are called to live a life that is one that is thankful at all times for all circumstances. We are to be thankful with the smallest of blessings so that we may be even more thankful in the gift of eternal life. We are to acknowledge that Christ is with us each day and every moment. There will be hardships, there will be tough times in our lives, but there's always a blessing somewhere when our basic needs are met. When the kindness of a stranger comes into our lives, these are blessings in which we should give thanks to God. This week, as we get close to the Thanksgiving holiday, it's a time we are thinking about being thankful a little more. But it's really a calling for us to do each and every day. A small blessing each day takes acknowledgement. If we can't give God thanks for the small blessings, how are we expected to receive the large blessings that come to us in the next life? We've been offered eternal life through Christ Jesus. For us to be thankful for that, we must be thankful for all the blessings that God gives us. I hope you have a blessed day.